Hello everyone, welcome to Gokul Global University. Our today's topic is the inner product space. So, inner product space is a part of advanced linear algebra. In this video, I am going to brief introduction about the inner product space. So, let's start. First of all, outline. First is introduction, second one is norm of the vector, third one is examples of a inner product space, fourth one is angle between vectors, and last one is Gram-Schmidt method or Gram-Schmidt process. Okay, so last I will start with the define some notation of a inner product space. So inner product space. First is that what is inner product? Okay, so definition of a inner product, let U, V and W be vectors in a vector space V, and let C be any scalar of the field, and inner product on V is a function that associate real numbers in bracket U, V with each pair of a vectors U and V and satisfies the following assumption or conditions. Okay, so sometimes we define the inner products in a triangular brackets. So what is the condition? The first condition is that in a inner product space U comma V is equal to V comma U. Okay, so commutative is hold. Second thing is that in the inner products in bracket U comma V plus W is equal to in bracket U comma V plus U comma W. Okay, second next is C in bracket U comma V is equal to C of U comma V, and last one is that if V comma V greater or equal 0, then V comma V is equal to 0. Okay, so these four property are satisfied, then the space or the product is said to be a inner product. Now next one is that notation and definition or define how to define the inner product space. So first is that U dot V is equal to dot product is the definition of inner products for the Euclidean spaces. Okay, second thing is that in bracket U comma V, so general inner product for a vector space V. Usually we can define the triangular basis for the inner product spaces. So a vector space V with an inner product is called a inner product space. How can we define a vector space and inner product space? So we can see that vector space is defined as a normal bracket, normal open bracket V comma plus comma dot, usual notation of dot and addition, okay, multiplication and addition. And second one is inner product space. So inner product space is defined for the spaces V comma addition notation, multiplication and triangular basis. Okay, now properties of a inner products. Let U comma V and W be a vectors in an inner product space V, and let C be any real number, then which are the properties satisfies? So first one is that 0 comma V is equal to V comma 0 is equal to 0. Okay, first property is that. Second property is U plus V comma W is equal to U comma V plus V comma W. Okay, third one is that U comma CV is equal to C in bracket UV. Fourth one is that U minus V comma W is equal to U comma W minus V comma W. And last one is that u comma v minus w is equal to u comma v minus u comma w. Okay. Now we are going to discuss on notation about the norm or the length of u. So what is the norm and how can we define the norm spaces or norm? So norm of u is equal to square root of u comma u. Okay. And notation of a square root, we can remove the square root, then we can also define the second thing, norm of u square is equal to u comma u. Now what is the distance between u and v? Okay, what is the distance between vectors u and v? So we can use the formula or notation, distance of uv is equal to norm of u minus v, and that is the under root of u minus v comma u minus v. It is same of the norm for u square is equal to under root of u comma u. So similarly we define u minus v. Now angle between two non-zero vectors u and v, what is the angle between two vectors? So cos theta is equal to in bracket u comma v upon norm of u into norm of v is the angle between two vectors, and here theta is between 0 to pi. Okay, what is the orthogonality or orthogonal? Okay, so here if u orthogonal v, then u comma v is equal to 0. So u and v are orthogonal, then u comma v is equal to 0. So angle between u and v is 0, then we can say that is orthogonal. Now distance between two vectors, so the distance between two vectors satisfies the same property and same notation. Okay, we already done, this is the other properties, property of a particular distance. So first is that distance of uv greater or equal 0 always. Second one is that if distance of uv is equal to 0, if and only if u is equal to v. Third one is that commutative law, and second one is, last one is that distance of uv less or equal distance of uw plus distance of w comma v. Okay. Now what is the, how can we find the distance between two vectors? So let understand the example. The distance between u is equal to, what is the value of u? So 0, 2 and 2, and v is equal to 2, 0 and 1. So we can use a formula for the distance between of a two vector, finding distance of u comma v is equal to norm of u minus v is equal to norm of 0 minus 2, 2 minus 0 and 2 minus 1. So value of this is minus 2 square under root of minus 2 square plus 2 square plus 1 square, it is 3. So distance of given two vector, how we can find value of this? So here two vectors are given 0, 2, 2 and 2, 0, 1. Its distance is 3. Now angle between the vectors. So angle between the vector, how to find the angle? So for any non-zero vectors, okay, for a non-zero vectors u and v in an inner product space v, the angle between u and v is defined to be the angle theta, such that theta in between 0 and pi. Okay, so cos theta is equal to uv upon norm of u into norm of v. We have already seen that. Now finding the theta, so example is that consider the vector, find the angle theta between u and v, find the angle between two vectors. Okay, here two vectors is u and v. So first of all, value of u is equal to 2, 3 and 5, and value of v is equal to 1 minus 4 and 3 in a space R3. Okay, so we already know about the formula of angle. So cos theta is equal to value of u into value of v under root of norm of u and norm of v. Okay, how we can find the norm of u and v, we can also seen in a next slide, in previous slide. Okay, so we can use this formula, apply the inner product space or apply the multiplication, so we can find the value of cos theta is equal to 0.159. okay, and theta is equal to cos inverse 0.159. so this is the value of the angle between the vector v and vector u. Now next one is orthogonal vectors. So two vectors u and v in Rn are orthogonal. Okay, is orthogonal if, what is condition of orthogonal? So if u and v are the two vectors and is orthogonal if u dot v is equal to 0. Okay, so here important note is that the vector 0 is said to be orthogonal to every vector. Okay, this is a useful for a short question also. What is the orthogonal to every vector? So the 0 vector is said to be a orthogonal to every vector. Now finding orthogonal vectors. So determine all vectors in Rn that are orthogonal to u is equal to 4 and 2. So solution is that u is equal to 4, 2. Let v is equal to v1 and v2. Okay, here we can find the value of v1. So u dot v is equal to 4 into 2, 4 comma 2 into v1 into comma v2. Okay, so multiply this 4v1 plus 2v2. Here vectors is, we can also know that what is the main important thing for the orthogonal vectors. So orthogonal vector are for a dot product u dot v is equal to 0. Okay, so here value of the v1 is equal to minus t by 2 and v2 is equal to t. So orthogonal vector of a u is v is equal to minus t by 2 and t, for t belongs to real number r. Now we can see the Pythagorean theorem. Okay, what is Pythagorean property or Pythagoras theorem? We already know about this. If u and v are vectors in Rn, then u and v are orthogonal if and only if norm space or the norm of u plus v square is equal to norm of u square plus norm of v square. This is known as a Pythagorean property. Next is a dot product and matrix multiplication. So what is the matrix multiplication and what is dot product? Here given that u is equal to column vector u1 u2 up to un and v is equal to v1 v2 up to vn. okay, in Rn represented is that n cross 1 column matrix. If u dot v is equal to u transpose dot v, then what is the transpose of this vector? So number of row change into number of column is called a transpose. So here number of column vector convert into the number of row vector. So u1 u2 up to un is a row vector, and what is column vector? v1 v2 v3 up to vn. So u dot v is equal to number of first row vector multiply with the number of first column vector. This is a multiplication of a matrix. We already know about this multiplication. Next one is that Gram-Smith process. What is the Gram-Smith process or method? So Gram-Smith process or method is that let W be a subspace of a vector space Rn with a set S is equal to U1, U2, U3 up to UK. Then an orthogonal set S' is equal to V1, V2 up to VK. And an orthonormal set S double dash is equal to W, W1, W2 up to WK can be found the following steps. Okay, then first step is that take V1 is equal to U1. Second is that use the following formula to find other orthogonal vectors. So V2 is equal to U2 minus U2 into V1 upon V1 into V1 bracket close into V1. Now formula of finding V3 is equal to U3 minus U3 dot V1 upon V1 into V1 bracket close multiplication of V1 minus U3 dot V2 upon V2 into V2 in bracket close into V2. Now this is same formula for a VI. VI is equal to UI minus U1, so UI dot V1 upon V1 dot V1 bracket close into V1, so minus UI into V2 upon V2 into V2 in bracket close V2 minus up to VI minus 1. So S dash is equal to V1, V2, V3 up to VK is an orthogonal set. Okay, so S dash is called an orthogonal set. Now we can find the formula for an orthonormal set or orthonormal vector. So to find the orthonormal vectors, let WI is equal to VI upon modulus, norm of VI. I is equal to 1, 2 running from K. Okay, thus S double dash is equal to, this is the set of an orthonormal set for W, and vectors of this is a W1, W2, WK. So this is a process for the Gram-Smith method. Next one is that Gram-Smith orthogonalization process. So we can use this process for the finding orthogonal basis and orthonormal basis. So first one is that B is equal to U2, U3 up to UN is a basis for an inner product space V. From the method of a Gram-Smith, first let U1 is equal to V1. So value of U1 is equal to value of V1. Now second one is V2. V2 is equal to U2 minus projection of W1. And what is W1? Span of vector VI. Then U2 is equal to U2 minus U2, V1 upon V1 upon V1 into V2. Okay. And similarly, the formula of a V3 is that, what is the W? W is equal to span of a two vectors of a span of a basis. W1 and W2 define the span of V1 and span of V1, V2. Now in the same process, Vn is equal to Un of a projection or Wn minus 1. When what is the value of a Un? Un is equal to Un minus summation of I running from 1 to n minus 1 Un, Vi upon Vi, Vi into Vi. So here V1, V2 up to Vn is equal to B dash is an orthogonal basis. Okay. And second one is that B double dash is equal to in bracket V1 upon norm of V1, V2 upon norm of V2 up to so n Vn upon norm of Vn is an orthonormal basis. So this Gram-Smith process or Gram-Smith method is very useful to find orthogonal basis an orthonormal basis. We can, using this method, solve this problem, this type of orthogonal and orthonormal basis, and find the vectors or a basis for orthogonal and orthonormal basis. Suppose we take u1 is equal to 1 1 0, u2 is equal to 1 2 0, and u3 is equal to 0 1 2, then for the using or use of a orthogram-Smith method, we can find the orthogonal basis and orthonormal basis, and this is the b' v1 v2 v3 is equal to 1 1 0, -1/2, comma -1/2 0, and third vector is that 0 0 2, and value of a orthonormal basis b double dash is equal to v1 upon norm of v1, comma v2 upon norm of v2, comma up to so n vn upon norm of vn is that given vector 1 upon √2, comma 1 upon √2 0, comma second vector is given that, and last one is given that. So it is the basis for orthogonal and orthonormal basis. Thank you for watching this video. We will learn about some example for this process in our next video lecture.